Hey guys, Tyler here, and today we are looking at an expert level word problem. So go ahead and pause your video, give yourself a few minutes to try this one on your own, and then we'll take a look at the solution. All right, welcome back. We are going to look at the solution here. Full disclosure, this is a very complex problem. A whole bunch of stuff is going on here, so let's kind of just unpack a bit of this. So my main man, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, has a bean farm. He's got 70 acres here, but these two kinds of beans produce different yields, right? So pinto, you get 36 bushels an acre. Navy, you get a little less, 27 bushels an acre. And we want to know if Dwayne has twice as many bushels of pinto in the end, how many acres of pinto did he start with? Wow. So off the bat, I can tell you when I first tried this one, I tried to do it algebraically and it was a mess. I got all turned around, did not get the correct answer, but I want to show you guys an alternate technique here that I think will help you out, something called backsolving. So as stated, if the algebraic equations aren't coming to you, you might want to try backsolving. The other big element to backsolving here is if I look at my answer choices and I notice they are all integers that I could plug in, then I've got the green light. If these had been fractions or decimals or something that's going to be nasty to plug in, I don't necessarily want to backsolve. But here, they're integers. They go in ascending order. So all good to go there. Next thing I want to look at is kind of the ultimate question being asked, right? How many acres of pinto beans did he plant? So that implies each answer choice here represents my acres of pinto. So if I've got some amount of pinto, the other piece of that is I'm gonna have some acres of navy. How many? Well, remember we have 70 total acres. So what I wanna do here to backsolve effectively, I only wanna test choice B and choice D. Right? I only use those two answers because if it's not B or D themselves, I can use the relationship between B and D to determine the correct answer. So let's start with B and see what happens. If I have 30 acres of pinto, to get the 70 total acres, I would need 40 of navy. From there, I got to think about my totals, right? I've got these bushel counts coming in. So my total pinto, that's gonna be the 30 acres I start with, and then it's gonna get multiplied by 36 bushels. So 30 times 36, I know that's 3 times 360. I played enough Tony Hawk to tell you that 3 times 360, that's gonna be 1080. On the Navy side of things, I've got 40 acres. So my total Navy is gonna be 40, and then I have 27 bushels per acre. 40 times 27, I might grab a calculator for that. That one's less intuitive, but in the end, you're also gonna get 1080. So what do I do with those two numbers? Well, remember our goal here, we want twice as many pinto as navy. So our pinto amount should be double the navy amount. Here, those two are actually equal. So I know it can't be B, right? I didn't achieve my goal there. But let's try choice D, see what happens. So if I have 40 acres of pinto, I have to have 30 acres of navy to get to 70. And those 40 of pinto still have 36 an acre. So 40 times 36, that's gonna be a 1440. On navy, I now have 30 acres, 27 an acre, that's the same amount. But 40 times 27, that'll get me 810. Did I meet my goal there? Not quite, right? 810, double that would be 1620. So I didn't quite do it, but I did get closer, right? And here's the power of backsolving. Recall that all these answer choices, they're in ascending order, right? And we've seen that as I increased my acres of pinto, I got closer to my goal. D didn't quite achieve it, but because I'm getting closer as I increase the acres of pinto, that means the answer has to be E. There's only one other possibility there. So E is the only one bigger. There's your answer. If this were the real test, I'd say we're done, but I'll go ahead and plug in E for you guys so you can see what happens. So if I had 42 acres of pinto, that means I would need 28 of navy to get the 70. And then in terms of total, I would have 42 times 36. That would be 1512. And for navy, you would have 28 times 27, and that would be 756. And voila, right? 1512 is double 756, so you know the correct answer is E. All right, guys, that was Backsolving. I hope you found that useful. Check out our playlist for some more math videos and tell us your favorite bean in the comments.